A state Labor MP is tonight at the centre of explosive allegations that his office has been infiltrated by Chinese spies. ASIO and the Australian Federal Police today raided the home and parliamentary office of Shaquette Mosselmein. 60 Minutes and Sydney Morning Herald journalist Nick McKenzie broke the story.
A little-known Labor politician with a big problem. Shaquette Mosselmein, the focus of an investigation by our national security agencies into allegations of interference by the Chinese Communist Party.
Thank you.
Agents from ASIO and the Federal Police raided Mr. Mosselmein's home in Rockdale in Sydney South, gathering evidence to support allegations of a potential Chinese government plot on Australian soil.
We won't cop anyone coming and seeking to interfere in our political system.
The warrants authorised by the Commonwealth Attorney General, a big step, given one of the targets was Mosselmein's office deep inside the New South Wales Parliament.
It's been an investigation that has been going on for some time. It's taken it's elevated to a new level today.
The focus of the investigation is whether Mr. Mosselmein's office has been compromised by the Communist Party in a bid to push China's interests in Australia. His brother describing it as racism.
They want to victimise him because they are against China. Racism is working against Mr. Shaquette Mosselmein. It's very clear.
The MP's home was searched for hours as part of one of the most significant investigations in ASIO's recent history.
The Chinese government should be commended for the immediate action that it took. I actually heard Xi Jinping speak about this.
This was Shaquette Mosselmein in March, praising China's handling of the coronavirus pandemic.
Because it was contained so much in China, that meant that the rest of the world had not been affected.
He resigned his position as Assistant President of the Upper House, a largely ceremonial role, but one that gave him access to foreign diplomats in Sydney.
This is, as far as I'm concerned, the most un-Australian act that anybody could be involved in.
A Lebanese migrant and solicitor, Mosselmein served three stints as mayor of Rockdale Council before entering the New South Wales Upper House in 2009 as the first Muslim member. Since then, he's taken at least 9 trips to China, some costs paid for by Communist Party officials. In 2018, he gave a speech saying for China to reach its potential, it must force a change to the rules and create a new world order, and has since labelled white Australia as obsolete scum.
Today is not the first time China dominated the world.
Even after all of this, it took an ASIO raid for his party leader to sack him.
He will no longer sit in the caucus. He will no longer be a Labor Party member. His membership is being suspended as we speak.
Nine News is not suggesting Mr. Mosselmein is guilty of any wrongdoing, only that he is under investigation. But his support of China's communist government is not in dispute. The question ASIO is asking is why. Nick McKenzie, Nine News.
Well, federal political reporter Chris O'Keefe joins me now in the studio. Chris, extraordinary allegations. What are the ramifications for the Labor Party?
Well, it's extraordinary in many ways, Georgie. Labor keeps telling us it is trying to disentangle itself from murky dealings, but it's obviously a slow process that continues to eat away at the party's credibility. You have to remember, just in the last few years, you have seen Sam Dastyari go for his links to China, an ICAC investigation that destroyed the New South Wales party boss, and another MP for taking $100,000 cash from a Chinese property developer who also happened to be on an ASIO watch list. And then you had all the corruption allegations in the Victorian party. This is significant, though, because if Mr. Mosselmein is charged under foreign interference laws, it will be the first prosecution of its kind relating to China, Georgie, anywhere in the world.
Amazing. All right, Chris, thank you.